Dear Father Patrick, Father Haile Mariam, the Holy Provincial with us, Youth Ministry delegates, economists and PDO directors, PTVETs, PJSOs, all people following us online, my colleagues at DPTA office, and good afternoon. We are at the conclusion of ASA 2021. I would like to begin by thanking God for His goodness and protection over us during this past 1 week. In this time of the pandemic, the Lord has given us strength and protection. We had relatively a large group during this ASA, the economists and PDO directors, youth ministry delegates, PTVETs and PJSOs. The main reason for inviting all these different important stakeholders was to strengthen the effectiveness of our network on the ground and be more effective in our interventions in the technical centers where we meet our young people. So, it was a time of professional and mission-oriented bonding, both with DBTA office and within our own provinces. Clear definition of roles and responsibilities help us to respect one another and at the same time work as a team in our mission to the young. Some of the conclusions from the deliberations that we have had would be: 1. Promote the DBTA network and build a sense of belongingness and ownership right from the TVET center level, and it begins with us. I hope this meeting together with the team building exercises have helped us in this process. Stephen spoke of funding opportunities. Please let us make use of it, and our support as an office will be there for you. 3. Improve on the coordination work of the youth ministry delegates in the provinces. As I thank them for their presentations on their involvement in the TVET centers, I would also encourage them to take charge and coordinate this important sector of our mission in the province. We have worked on the role of the province youth ministry delegate in the province in relation to TVET centers. Let us act on it as we go back to our provinces. 4. I would also request the active participation and collaboration of the Office of the Economer and PTO in their twofold function. 1. In their responsibility to the DBTA office in the efficient implementation of the projects and reporting, and secondly, in supporting the TVET centers through the office of the province youth ministry delegate and the PTVET office. 5. We had long sessions on the social structure fund program and global program work packages, and later on, very many individual meetings for clarifying issues and looking at possibilities in our provinces. I hope this is going to help us for better implementation of our programs and make good use of all the opportunities that are there within these programs. From the SSFP, I would request your special attention on the quality management framework and system that we would want to develop. This is the only way we can be recognized and our students can be recognized in the job market. From the global program, I would want you to focus on the capacity building initiatives for our center management through the ITCILO. For those who have completed the course, to begin implementing what they have learned, and for those still to do the course, to take it seriously, all for our young people. 6. I would like to stress once more the issue of management information systems and data management. The more the information we have, the better the opportunities for projects, networking, and empowerment for our personnel and institutions. We spent quite a lot of time explaining the various surveys and databases. We spoke of the baseline surveys, surveys for our training needs, graduate trace study from Francophony, DBTA database, etc. Let us give a serious thought to it and please support us in this effort. 7. The learning management system being developed in its initial stages, but with a great future and a great opportunity for all of us, and especially for the young people. Let us promote it both by using it and by contributing to it as well. 8. We had an interesting sharing from DBTech ASEAN. There are lots of things to learn and even exchange. We need to learn and work on advocacy and influencing policy. Another important aspect stressed by Father Dindo was on upgrading our training interventions so that our young people will have access to better jobs and better remuneration and better quality of life. Our labor market survey also speak about it. And of course, the message from Father Miguel Angel was precisely that. The option for the poor should not be a poor option, but we need to work on quality because of our young people. Even if they are poor, they deserve the best. I want now to encourage you all to take this up. Let us not be afraid to drop some of our obsolete trades for something better and modern. If we start a new training center, let it be something more innovative and in line with the science of the times. 9. Father Patrick reminded us that at a congregational level, Tibet is seen under three pillars of employment, e-learning, and ecology. We can proudly say that we are into all three. Father Patrick also reminded us that change is possible. Change is gradual, and it begins with you. And we have seen in our network. So, let us not get discouraged, but take it upon as my personal responsibility in transforming the Tibet sector in my province and through my efforts transform the lives of the young people entrusted to us. Dear friends, thank you very much for your presence in person and online. My special words of appreciation to Father Alphonse, the Youth Ministry Department, we are also represented by Father Patrick, and the whole General Council. Their support has been great. The provincials for having allowed you to travel and for their constant support to DBTA. To our donors, especially BMZ, and the funds coming to us through Monto. The people at Monto, they have not only supported the project financially, but also have journeyed with us. Miss Sylvia, Roland, Strux, and Stefan, they have been very close to us. They have all been part of this meeting as well. I would like to thank in a special way all those people who have made presentations. Especially Father Alphonse, Father Patrick, Father Dindo, Stefan Gross, Brother John, Roland, DBTA staff, SAM team, and the Francophony team. As we go back to our provinces, let us go back with renewed enthusiasm. Let us keep up the momentum. Let us keep up the communication with DBTA and also, I would like to stress this, within your provinces. And with these words, I would like to conclude our first ASA of 2021. Thank you very much.